Because it's differently believed that
he was born in a human form.
And
who was born? Jesus Christ was born or God was born?
Jesus Christ was born
in human form.
That's where it comes in with the Trinity, because the Holy Spirit, because he also has the Holy Spirit.
The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit,
So, clarify for me. Is Jesus Christ God?
No, he's not God.
He's the Son of God.
Yeah.
Okay. So then you can't disagree with my statement. God wasn't born. God doesn't have offspring. Can we move on? No, tell me. Because the thing is,
we believe that God doesn't have offspring. That's what we believe. God's only Son is what He gave to us.
Yeah. Okay. So
because God,
God had God children.
God had
he
a child.
He had a child. He didn't have a physical.
God doesn't present. He can only be presented in a different form. That's a human being. That's how he's presented. Jesus Christ is what God, but God is represented in Jesus' human form.
Say that again. I'm going to pay attention. Go on.
God is God. We don't have pictures of God, but God is presented in
through Jesus Christ.
And that's how it comes.
Represented or Jesus Christ is God?
No, Jesus Christ.
Because did Jesus Christ come as a messenger of God, as someone who was sent by God? So then God doesn't have offspring. Because right now, you're going to get caught up on the word the child of God. Yeah? But are the disciples referred to as children of God?
Yeah, but as a whole, we're all children of God.
Well,
right?
I'm a child of God.
I would say
so. Are you an offspring of God?
I'm not.
I think it's just a way of saying that, you know, God loves us all equally in His eyes. You know what I mean?
So, does God have children? Does God have offspring?
Does God have nieces and nephews?
Does God have nieces and nephews?
No, but Jesus,
brothers and sisters.
God is not human.
He's not the same as us.
I agree. Thank you. By the way, that's the fourth verse. Yeah, that's the fourth verse. There's nothing comparable to God. Yeah. So we don't worship the Creator. We worship the creation. Yeah. So we're saying, don't compare the Creator with the creation. So you're saying Jesus Christ being offspring of God. What kind of if Jesus Christ, there's a difference between being of God and being the child of God and being the child of God. I'm gonna repeat myself. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So are you looking for something?
Oh, no.
No, that's fine. So would you say Jesus Christ, so going back to what I was saying, sorry, very quickly, Jesus Christ, I mean, does God have offspring? Because if you're going to conflate the two words where Jesus Christ is the Son of God, but then there are other children of God, yeah, then it makes it a bit of a non-point. And I'm saying, what's easier to digest?
We believe God chose Mary
because she was the only one that was chosen. She was the sinless one. So Jesus was given birth through Mary.
Muslims, we affirm of God in a way.
We're not his offspring, but all children.
We as Muslims affirm Mary was pure. Mary gave birth through Jesus without any male intervention. It was a miraculous birth. Yeah.
And she couldn't have done that without God. She can't just give birth without male.
Through the permission of God. As a Muslim, we don't have an issue with that. But we're not saying that God has offspring, God has partners, there's an equal to God, or there's. Does that make sense? Because when you say Trinity, because again, we're kind of going all over the place. We need to kind of decide.
I don't think there's one decision. I think there's going to be an opinion. My opinion is we are all children of God. If you are a Christian and you follow God's teachings, the biblical teachings, you are a child of God. You're seen as a child of God. I'm a child of God. We're all children of God. But I wouldn't say all as in every single religion, because every single religion...
No, leave every single religion. So right now, you're all children of God. So are you all the offspring of God?
We're not the offspring.
No, we're not the offspring, but we are.
But then,
it's metaphorical.
Yeah. then is Jesus Christ metaphorically the child of God?
No, he is the child of God.
He is the child of God.
Because God created him in a way, because it wasn't Mary.
Wait, based on what? Where are you getting this belief from?
The Bible.
Tell me. Where in the Bible, like specific? You don't need to give me references, like, because we'll just have an informal conversation.
Like where?
Back up with something, and then I'll see if it's in the Bible.
Like, no, like where it explained, because she was pure, she was the chosen one to give birth to
the Son of God. No other woman can do that. No other woman on this earth can get pregnant without a male. Mary was the only one. Therefore, he is the Son of God.
You know the Quran replies to this argument. And it says, Adam was born, was created without a male or a female. Eve, in the Bible, in the Quran, known as Hawa, was created without a female. Yeah? So, do you worship Adam, peace be upon him? Because he was made in a special way.
I don't worship Jesus. You don't work in the Bible.
Then he's not God then.
He's not God. But
then you have to reject Trinity. Doesn't make sense.
I'm not gonna reject.
Yeah, here it is. Angel Gabriel, he gave the message to God, and to Mary, for the favor of God, and like it says that she will bear the Son of the Most High. Of the Most High and the Lord God. So like that, there's.
Where's the reference for that?
It's what the angel said to
Yeah, but who are you calling? Where are you getting that from? Specifically?
It's from our teacher.
But at the end of it, I think.
And by the way, sorry, go on, Alex.
I just think that, you know, I wouldn't dismiss the Trinity because that's what I was raised on. That's what I.
By the way, I'm not forcing you, I'm not pressuring you, I'm not burdening you. But what I'm trying to say is, how can you have contradicting beliefs? One minute you're saying Jesus Christ isn't God.
Yeah, but can I say something?
Sorry, let me just finish this point. One minute you're saying Jesus Christ isn't God. Yeah, and I agree with you. Then you're saying you believe in Trinity, which means that you believe the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, the co-equal, the eternal, the same. Yeah? Then, as the conversation would continue, I can show you verses and evidences where Jesus Christ, there's a difference between him and the Father, him and God. And he himself is saying that in John 17:3, that the only true God and the one that was sent by him. So then at least, because before we go to is Jesus Christ the Son of God, like we need to build on something. It's either the Trinity makes sense or it doesn't make sense. The Bible, we need to follow it verbatim or we don't follow it. Does it make sense? So it's going all over the place. So my point is, you can't 1 minute say he's the Son of God, yeah, and he's not divine, and then next minute say no, he is divine, and then kind of lean on the Trinity, and then go on.
I just feel like everything contradicts each other. I've never.
What contradicts each other?
I'm not really someone that I've read the Bible, but I couldn't quote anything from my head. But I'm just gonna say that in every holy book, I believe there is contradiction, and at the end of the day.
No, you can't make that claim. You can speak from the perspective of the Bible, but have you read the Quran?
I have not personally read it.
But have you? Then how can you say that there's contradictions in it?
So do you think there's no contradiction?
There is no contradiction. The Quran categorically says it's from God, Allah, and Allah will preserve it. Yeah. Now, if there is a contradiction in the Quran, I'll reject it to be a fabrication. It's not from God. If there's a single mistake in it, because my creed as a Muslim, there's one God. God created all of us with a purpose, told us what that purpose is through prophets and messengers, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon all of them. After they die, the message lives on through a perfect book, which is the Quran, which is a perfect revelation from God. God is a master of all things. So when the Quran talks about science, it gets it right. When it talks about history, it gets it right. When it makes prophecies, it gets it right. Yeah.
So what, you're trying to say the Bible doesn't get it right? Or the Bible contradicts it?
It does contradict itself.
I'm saying I agree with you guys that there's man-made elements gone into it. There's contradictions.
You're saying
you're following the Bible, it contradicts yourself. You're getting the commandments, you're getting a way of life of what to do, what not to do, from a book which you've already said contradicts itself.
It does, but at the same time, what it tells us.
Who should we follow? A book that contradicts itself or Jesus Christ's teaching?
That doesn't matter to me, because if I'm following the Ten Commandments, at the end of the day, God is still God.
Ten Commandments. What's the first commandment? What's the first commandment?
I don't know what the first
commandment is. Google it. The first commandment out of the Ten Commandments. The first of the Ten Commandments. And then I'll show you how you're not even following it.
Where are you guys? Do I need to come?
Are the two the same person or different people?
No, she's different.
Now you guys got a big crowd of people, that's how I saw you.
Yeah, because we're supposed to be something.
Yeah. I am the Lord thy God.
Wait, spell it. Carry on.
I don't know how to read.
I was just like, you can read it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It says it's starting in 6 minutes.
Okay. Thou shalt not have no other gods beside me.
Right.
Yeah? So, how many gods is it talking about? Is it saying Trinity? Moses never taught Trinity.
I mean, he doesn't have to say Trinity for me to really talk about Trinity. At the end of the day, I just think
I respect your right to believe what you want to believe, but where is that belief coming from, and is that belief going to take you to paradise or hellfire? Is your belief contradicting what Moses taught? Yes, because Moses didn't teach Trinity. Is it contradicting what the Bible taught? I mean, what Jesus Christ taught? Yes, because Jesus Christ never taught Trinity. Yeah. Now look, this is an ongoing conversation. Go home, do your independent research. Doesn't make sense. I'm not here to like insult you and kind of undermine Christianity, but I'm just saying, wait, why do you believe what you believe if Jesus Christ didn't teach it? If Moses didn't teach it? And then you're saying the Bible has contradictions in it, but then even the Bible didn't teach Trinity.
I do understand. It was great. I mean, you gave me a different insight on.
No, thank you.
And my Christianity.
Can I give you a Quran?
Oh yes, please. Yeah.
Yeah. Can I give you one more for your two friends as well?
Yeah, thank
you. How many do you want? It's free of charge, by the way.
Can I have two?
Yeah, two more. I'm gonna give you two more. I'm gonna give you this, and yeah, thank you. Let me just bring it for you. So.
From your Bible, I'm not lying. Okay, come on in English.
Here you go. Would you be curious to read the Quran?
Yeah.
Here you go.
Is it in English?
It's in English, yes.
Okay, thank you.
I saw you guys got a big group of friends.
Yeah.
On your way back, if you guys want more, it's free of charge.
All right.
And if you got any questions, we're here every Saturday. Thank you so much for being
thank
so friendly and polite. I appreciate
nice
that. I don't shake hands with him.
Oh,
my apologies.
Okay, sorry, my
and just very quickly, that's because for religious reasons, if you're not like my sister or my daughter, I don't have the right to touch you, basically,
okay,
unless we're in marital relations.
Thank you.
God bless you. You take care.